you no go make her forget the good love. Want me to get no free tongue. If I don't catch you, France, America, England, and Jamaica, I go come back now saloon. Pick up my love, make her talk complain. Once within a...
Hello, viewers. Welcome to the GUOSA Language Television in partnership with CreateTV.org of San Jose here in California, United States. Today we are studying the GUOSA language, a Nigerian and West African regional future lingua franca for unity, identity, political stability, and guess what? African Industrial Revolution. Like the Swahili for the East Africa, so is the GUOSA language for the West Africa. GUOSA is an evolution of words from West African nations to make a united language for our people. Today we're going to study some simple vocabularies or words in the GUOSA language. And we're starting with, when I say ekuabia, I write it here. Ekuabia. You see, eku is a Yoruba word, and bia is an Igbo word meaning welcome. Welcome. Okay, now you cannot ask me welcome to where? Welcome home. You can say welcome back home. In which case, in the GUOSA language, you say ekuabia si gida. I repeat, ekuabia si gida. You see, eku is Yoruba, Bia is Igbo, si Yoruba, and then Gida is Hausa. That is how GUOSA language works. It thrives with the languages and words of all the West African nations. And then, when you say ekuabia si Gida, then you say, if you can just say Shendo, or if you like, eku Gida, meaning compliment to you at home. I write it. Eku Gida. See. Eku Gida. Eku is Yoruba. And Gida is Hausa. And then, like I said, Eku Abia. These two words are Yoruba and Igbo languages. But when you move on to add Gida, you now have Yoruba, Hausa, Igbo, and Yoruba. In other words, ekuabia si Gida. On the same note, with ekuabia, you cannot say ekuabia si Nigeria. Welcome to Nigeria. Ekuabia si Casa America. Welcome to the land of America. Ekuabia si Makaranta. What is Makaranta? Makaranta is an Hausa word. Let me write it down. Makaranta. That meant school. Ekuabia si Makaranta. Welcome to the school. Ekuabia si Sule. Sule is another word. Sule. Sule, meaning farm in the Tiv language. Tiv, which is T-I-V. Tiv is one of the ethnic groups in Nigeria. So, with ekuabia, you can continue on and on and on. Ekuabia si irushe. Irushe is work. Ekuabia si anywhere. Not anywhere, you know what I mean. So, with ekuabia, you can go on and on to add whatever you want. Then, we move further to say bia, which is come. Bia, B-I-A. Bia meant come in an Igbo language. So when you say biambi, meaning come here, aboki biambi, friend, come here, aboki biakawa shenga, come and let us go. Biakawa shenga kaswa, come and let us go to the market. What is kaswa? Kaswa, I write it down, K-A-S-U-A. Or if you like, K-A-S-U-W-A. Meaning market in the northern part of Nigeria. Ekwa bia kawashenga kaswa, come and let us go to the market. So, like I told you, GUOSA is a language from the West Africa, for the West Africa, and by the West Africa. That is linguistic democracy. So when you speak a language for the people of Nigeria and ECOWAS member nations, you have a language that has the interest of all the diverse ethnic groups and accomplishing unity in diversity. Until I come your way again, send your questions to us, GUOSA Language Television, in partnership with creativesanjose.org, and our telephone or telewire is 510-225-9172. Then, before I let you go, when I say shendo, I write it here, shendo, shendo, meaning thank you, thanks, or thank you. So, aboki, shendo, awagahu, baya, bayo. Bayo is an Ijaw word, meaning goodbye. Bayo, aboki.
comrade. Why you sorry? No, you can't. Why you live? Me, bonsoir. Yeah, I'm going to
Thank you. Nations Association here in the East Bay. We are delighted that you have come. Many of you are old-timers and have been to many of our monthly dinner forums. This is about our 36th one, where we have interesting, different, usually very timely topics where the community can get together and learn about issues that might be pertinent locally or certainly are of concern and relevant to us locally, but have a global dimension, which is what we in the United Nations do, the United Nations Association do, to try to fulfill those aspirations, goals of what the United Nations was created to do in the first place, recognizing that it is not a perfect institution, but it needs understanding and support as we address issues such as human rights, peace, gender equality, protecting the environment, all things that are embedded in the United Nations Charter. And so this is just one little event that our 121 chapters do around the country in the United States. We are one of about 75 national groups in the United Nations Association network globally, all trying to connect their countries better to the necessities and the opportunities to work for international cooperation. So that's a big picture. I wanted to use this as an opportunity to thank the organizers of this event, Mary Steiner, who I think just slipped out, as well as Veronica, who you'll hear from. Oh, there's Mary right in front. You're right in front of me. Who's head of the Dinner Forum Committee along with Dorothy Hirschberg. And Veronica has helped set up this program as well. We also want to thank very, very much the City of Oakland for access to this room, for their support to indicate that this is an issue, an opportunity that affects our cities all in Nigeria after the Human Rights Council of the United Nations also condemned the act. And today there was another report that came out from the United Nations Population Fund, which talked about the global dangers of early childhood marriage, including those who are forced into childhood marriage, and that one-third of the girls in the world are married under the age of 18 globally, and that of those, most of them are in Africa. That's a number that surprised me, but it's an issue, and of course protecting our girls and women and their rights and the culture that affects them is one of the global topics for tonight. So I'd like to welcome you. I would like to encourage you all to become involved in other things that we are doing. We're working on peace later in the year in several programs. We'll be celebrating that at several events, human rights and other things, and you have that flyer in front of you that has the outline of all the programs that we've done last year and the ones we've scheduled this year. So welcome and thank you very much. And I would like to turn over the program to Veronica, whose information you have read about online and in your handout. She's a gem. We're delighted that she's on our board of directors. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Herb. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Veronica Ufuimine, and I'm Nigerian, American, whatever that means. And I was born and raised in Lagos, which is for, and I'm saying that for the benefit of a lot of people that I talk to that live in Nigeria. But I'm from Delta State, originally Delta State. So we're very happy to have you all here. Thank you so much for taking time off of your really precious evening to sit and advocate for the release of our Nigerian girls. All we are saying is bring back our girls. Mm-hmm. So thank you for taking the time to sit with us today, because it's about telling the story of our Chibok girls. It's about telling the story of the status of women in Nigeria. It's about advocating for human rights, equal rights, educational rights, and all the rights for everyone, including our girls and our women, mm-hmm. and the underprivileged. Everybody has a right to the right for life, the right for dignity, the right for support, respect, and that's why we're here tonight. The right to choose where you want to be, what you want to do, and we know that you sitting here tonight is supporting that cause. We have a resolution, we have Muslim leadership to help you separate the myth from the reality so that we can focus on what the real issues are. So without further ado, again, I want to thank you for spending your night with us. And I want to welcome our panel who are ready to go. And we'll start off with main speaker tonight. If you please put your hands together for Professor Dr. Stabina Ivele-Ocha. Please put your hands together for her. Together, and you're about to totally be treated tonight. She's brilliant, vibrant, and I adore her, and I'm sure you know why I adore her at the end of this. And I also am going to bother her husband, who doesn't want to be invited up, but I'm going to call him anyway. He's Dr. Stephen Owa, who is actually the winner of the last election, the gubernatorial election in Benue State in Nigeria. Benue State is in the middle belt. He won, and we're still battling in court for him to get his space of being the governor of the state, and he's, hopefully we're encouraging him to run again. I think he will, because he needs to represent justice in Nigeria. So I'd like to welcome everyone, put your hands together, Dr. Steve Uba. Dr. Steve Uba and Professor Uba, they're both professors at Cal State University, East Bay. And to run as governor, he's on sabbatical, so wonderful. And we would like to invite Commissioner Linda Fadike Richardson. She's very precious to us in the Nigerian community. She's a leader. She does do things. We were at the rally at the United Nations Plaza just a few weeks ago. Professor Rita Moran, would you stand up for a moment? We were at the, she was at the rally, the Chief of Girls. We talked about it, she'll pursue that in Berkeley, and Commissioner Fadike Richardson said she'll pursue it in San Francisco, and you guys put your hands together, she has a resolution in her hand. Amazing, she's a doer, she just doesn't talk about it, she does it. So that's why she's our leader. And I'd like to invite Alhaji Mohammed, who is a Muslim leader in a Nigerian community. If you please come out and put your hands together, he will help us separate the reality from the community. And another speaker is, in our community, we have listserv, and we have those that advocate for the entire community, and I could do it alone. We have several of them, but one person that stands out is Mr. Dapo. If you please put your hands together for that. To make sure that every single Nigerian is included in the email group. So if you want anything to go to everyone, he's got it. And in advocacy, we work together to put the rally together at the United Nations Plaza. So it's a well-needed and respected community leader in our community. We have Swahili in the South Africa. We have a developing language called GUOSA for the West African region, and the founder of this GUOSA language, and also have local TV stations that Nigerians can log into, GUOSA TV. And I'd like to introduce our brother and Chief Igbinewaka. Please put your hands together for Chief So he's just going to sit from his chair because he's also recording the event. And Alhaji YK, if would you like to join us on the table, please? Alhaji YK is another Muslim leader who we really value. Anytime we have Nigerian events, we actually work really well together, Christians and Muslims. And it's the leadership that we're looking up to lead us well so that we can continue to coexist together. So when we have our event, we usually would invite our Christian leaders and our Muslim leaders to pray for us. So here we are. Thank you. So, we have a powerful panel. I believe I've invited all our speakers. Did I miss anyone out? So I'm going to hand the microphone over to our Professor Ivele-Ocha.
I usually don't do mics because I think what we do is without mics for the most part. So, but if you hear me better with this, then I'll use it.
Okay. Thank you very much for using the mic.
All right. You know, Dr. Okwebuna thought she was going to do this buy one, get one free thing. And this is not marketing. You just don't do stuff like that. So what I'm going to tell her is that while she may succeed tonight in buying one and getting one free, it won't happen always. You know? Before I get started, I want to make sure that my device works here. It's not working in the full view that I want. Let me see. But I want to thank you all. It's unusual on a Wednesday evening to have people fill a room to hear about women, you know, because it's not a very hot topic. But thanks for coming, and I promise that I'll do my best to make sure that you ask this panel of experts the questions that they need to answer. So I speak the answer. Don't ask me any questions. Okay? All right.